So here is the deal. I've just gotten a brief from Kea to design an ad poster. And honestly, I'm feeling too lazy to go through the whole process myself. So here's what I'm gonna do. Just going to copy the brief, go to Lovart, which is the first AI design agent, paste it here. Oh my God, that's impressive. So this is not bad, but still needs some tweaks. That is actually insanely good. I've developed a full visual identity, starting from the brainstorming, the initial ideas, going to refining this within text. Can you imagine that? With mockups, patterns, everything precisely how I wanted. I've also created a story out of one image, and with one click I have created a full story narrated with sound effects and music, and Lovart combined it all into one video. Can you imagine this? I'll show you all this later in the video. So today we are going to put Lovart into the test and see if it can be my new AI creative director agent beside me here. So without wasting any more time, let's dig into this. Hello guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Nour and this is Nour Art channel. All right, so what is Lovart? Lovart is the world's first design agent. So it thinks in design language, brings you references, it gets you into the strategy of thinking behind the design decision, and within just 5 days of launch, over 100,000 users from 70 plus countries have joined the waitlist. So this is something serious, guys. How does Lovart actually work? It's like a creative director who can put all the AI tools that we already know, like Google Image 3, like Kling, Flux Pro, Gemini, all these AI models, and it uses it into the proper context. And the best part, it's not just the AI models, it's a complete design tool. So let's have some use cases and see its capabilities. So what was in my mind that I want to create a visual identity for a brand, a gym brand, who is very luxurious, and it's called Power Fit. And what I asked Lovart to do is, I want to create a logo and visual identity elements for a brand called PowerFit. It's a Tiki fitness app. That's it. And it started to analyze what I've already asked him to see and started to gather the references and the inspirations. And it got some stuff like this one, as you can see, like this one. So it is not just an AI design tool. It puts you into the strategy, the thinking, and it opens your mind to new ideas. And then it developed this for logos. It is not bad. This one looks promising, but it doesn't have any concept. I told him that I kinda liked this logo, but it doesn't have any elements that refer to fitness. And then he generated this one. And this one looks kinda cool. He incorporated these muscles, the dumbbell with the V icon, but this is not bad, but it's kinda busy. There's a lot of stuff. And if you are designing this for a small icon, this will not be visible at all. You can imagine having an icon like this, you will not recognize what is already there. So I told him this is too much, that's it. And he understood it and started to give me simpler ones. This one looks okay, but it doesn't have a specific concept or something. Of course, I didn't give it details about the brand, but I wanted to test its capabilities. I asked him to give me more options. So he gave me these, and at this time, this is kind of promising, especially this one, because he incorporated the dumbbells with the P, brand name PowerFit. So I just right-click, send, add it to the chat, and asked him, this is promising, give me more solid options, minimal, and add the dumbbells. And this is very good in the inspiration stage. You are just generating variations with a snap. And after some trials, I told him that this is cool, give it gold with navy colors and recreate everything again. So this is like, I'm just imagining, I'm thinking, I'm putting the concept which is in my mind. So I should be a good designer, by the way, to judge the results and to say what is good and what is bad and to put my input into the design. Okay, so here is my ask. I give him this picture and told him to recreate everything again, but with this logo structure. And give me the following: the gold and navy color palette, the fonts, some patterns, all logo variations, horizontal and vertical, with different solid color options, and all the possible bags, watches, mobile screens, building, reception, business card with name, logo, and address, and phone details, everything, okay? And look at the final stuff that we have gotten. This is the color palette that I'm kind of 90% accepting it. This is the fonts, which is good, premium, and at the same time, kind of punchy. That's what I wanted. And look at this. This is very, very good. The end result here is very good. This is the gold variation with white color, the navy color with white background, and here is the vertical one. Pattern and the business card looks very premium. And here are the bags for the fitness app, the watches, the screens, and the building. This is very good. This is very good looking. And here is the reception. So yeah, here is a complete visual identity out of my thinking straight to the final result. So I can get all this and pitch it to the client. Very, very good. Let's jump into another use case for using Lovart into design world. So for this one, I used Lovart to create a poster with specific requirements into the poster. It's not just a general one, it's very specific. So I have a brief, and the main requirement is to create a poster for EV6 car. It's an electric car. So the main message is that EV6 car is electric, it's eco-friendly, it's the ideal choice for environmental conscious consumers, okay? So this is the main message. So what was in my mind is that I want to create a visual with the car. It should have a very good amount of green plants around. It should be in somewhere like in Dubai or Saudi markets, into the urban areas. So what I've done is that I went to Lovart. I sent him everything into the brief, and he started to put a plan. He went for ChatGPT to generate the image. He also started to analyze the strategy. He was thinking. So this is a very unique point in Lovart, because this is very neglected part of the design. He thought of everything and gave me this one. This one was not bad, but it is not what I wanted at all. Of course, I didn't give him enough information about what was in my mind. So I asked him, this is actually in Arabic, so it can be working in any language. So I told him that the sky is very dark and dull. I want the sky to be at the noon time, very bright and very colorful, okay? And I don't want three cars, I just want one car. And I want some element of electric cars like a charger. And I want the plant space to be bigger. I want a lot of plants. He gave me this one, and at this time, I was impressed actually, because this was 80% what was in my mind. He also put the text in a very good way with a very good color. Absolutely good. But the car model was not what I wanted. So I asked him to change the model to EV6. And I thought that it could be better to have a red car into this color combination. And I wanted to put Khalifa Tower here. And he gave me this one. And this one was amazingly done. Everything was exactly what I wanted. Of course, I can remove these windmills from here if I don't want it. So we can do this using the in paint. So I will just select this and just put here whatever I wanted. So I will just leave it blank. And look at this. After in painting, everything looks perfectly done. And then you can even put some text or whatever you want. It's a complete design tool. It's not just an AI model that gives you images. So you can insert images, you can import images, you can put text, some graphics elements like a rectangle, ellipse, brush, pin tool, you can crop, you can do everything you will do into Photoshop, even tweaking the colors. So you can press into the image and go here to the adjustments and you can just tweak the colors however you want. This is amazing. So let's get to the next use case. And this one was phenomenal, guys, because what I've asked Lovart is very simple. I've just given to him this image and asked him to generate a full story narrated with music and even develop the story itself. So here is my ask. I want to create a storyboard for a story based in this image. Just this one. He created the characters first and then created some scenes like this one, some close-ups, some story, but here he changed the mode. I maybe should have told him that we should have a consistent color grading throughout the whole story. Here, look at this. All these are shots and story from the story. And then he made the storyboard. The characters, the story, city, Alex and Maya, and then he created a video out of all this using Clang. And the best part on this is everything done here was automatic. I didn't tell him to make anything else. I've just asked him to make a story out of this image. That's it. And even when it finished, I'll show you the final result right now, but I want to show you that when it is done, I asked him to expand the story for another 1 minute. Can you imagine that? He created the videos, created the sound, created the music, and put everything together. I didn't even put this into any video editing software. He gave me the final result, and here is it.
This is it, Mia. The city of the past. Let's see what stories it holds. Imagine the lives that once filled these streets.
Okay.
They had dreams, just like us. Life finds a way.
The sky so gray, lost.
Maybe we can too. Let's build something new. Together, we can face whatever comes.
Tell their tales. Footsteps echo on fractured stones.
Great.
In this world where I'm alone. Fields of ash where dreams decay.
Something's off here.
It's so quiet here. Run. We should be safe here. Look at this. What do we do now?
We'll
find out what's next.
Look at
the
paints the view.
Oh.
But through the cracks, light filters through. I walk the ruins of what remains. Beauty blooms.
Wow. This was like a trailer from a movie. I really like it. Of course, it's not complete. Of course, there are a lot of, you know, AI things into the videos. And maybe the images were not consistent as the color grading is different from scene to scene. But the music is really good. Maybe the voiceover is not synchronized with the story. But you know what? This is very good for just 2 lines of text. Prompts. Okay. I was really impressed by this. And it can even create characters. So I asked him to create a character of a geek, nerdy guy with muscular body and with purple hair. Look at this. This is very cool. So there are a lot of use cases I've tried here, from product advertising designs to filmmaking to visual identity to scaling images. You can ask Lovart to create whatever whatever you want. And the best part, this is like a communicative agent. You can communicate with him. You want him to edit some specific parts and tweak it until you are satisfied. And that is what I really like about Lovart. So yeah, let me know, guys, in the comments what you think about Lovart, and get yourself into Lovart waitlist today. The link is in the description. And I've got 10 exclusive Lovart invite codes for early access. Just use one of the codes below and be quick, they'll go fast. Check out lovart.ai to be in the waitlist. And yeah, see you soon in next tutorial. Peace!